Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the premium file pack components within our SSIS Productivity Pack product. The SSIS Productivity Pack is a collection of premium SSIS components which enable greater developer productivity and increases the power of SSIS. As of this recording, the SSIS Productivity Pack offers 7 premium file pack components. The FTPS Connection Manager and SFTP Connection Manager establish the connections to the respective servers using the FTPS and SFTP API. The premium flat file source component can be used to read or retrieve data from a flat file. Premium flat file destination component allows you to write the contents to a flat file. Premium file transfer task is a control flow task that allows you to perform some basic file manipulations, including send and delete files, as well as create and remove directories. There is also the premium file system source component, which can be used to read, retrieve data from a file system. And lastly, premium file system destination component can be used to write data to a file system. All premium file pack components work with any compatible connections, including local file, SFTP, FTPS site, cloud storage such as Dropbox, OneDrive, SharePoint, with potentially more to come. Let's begin the demonstration, starting with the connection managers. It is useful to note that the premium file pack also supports connection managers from our other SSIS components to support some other cloud storage platforms, as we just mentioned, such as Dropbox, OneDrive, and SharePoint. In the Connection Manager area down below, right-click to add new connection. We will demonstrate the FTPS connection option first. Later on, we will show you what SFTP looks. We are now prompted to add in the following connection information. The first option you will notice in this interface is the host name, which represents a server containing your FTPS server. Passive mode is the default when connecting to your FTPS server. If this option is unchecked, it will use the active mode. You can specify either no encryption or TLS. When TLS is selected, the connection type is enabled. This specifies if you would like to connect to TLS through one of two modes, explicit or implicit. Port has two default values. Port 21 is defaulted when there is no encryption or when there is TLS encryption with the explicit connection type. Port 990 is defaulted when there is TLS encryption with implicit connection type. The next part of the form asks for the authentication information. The timeout is set to 120 seconds, but this can be adjusted. This determines the maximum amount of time that the connection manager will wait while trying to make a call to the server. In the advanced settings, there are optional proxy server settings in the case where a proxy may be required. As always, we should test the connection before hitting OK to ensure we are able to connect successfully. The second type of connection manager is for SFTP, which has different settings than the FTPS connection manager. We'll right-click the connection manager area down below to add a new connection and select the SFTP option type. Hostname behaves the same as before as a representation of the server containing your SFTP server. The port is defaulted to 22. Next is the authentication method, in which there are two methods, password or key. For the key option, you would also need to select the location of the key for your SFTP server in the path to key file field. You can then fill in the user and password fields. Choosing key as your authentication method also enables the file phrase field. The timeout settings for SFTP is also defaulted to 120 seconds, similar to FTPS. The advanced settings for SFTP is the same as you would find for the FTPS Connection Manager as well, where you can enter your proxy server information. Let's quickly test our SFTP connection before hitting OK. Please note that the two connection managers that we just created are package-level connection managers. For SSIS 2012 or later, you can create project-level connection managers if you right-click the Connection Managers node within the Solution Explorer. Let's drag the premium flat file source component to the surface of the data flow. Double-click to bring up its editor form. Here we will first specify the Connection Manager, which can be any compatible connections, such as the FTPS connection, the SFTP connection, or a local file. It's important to note that the premium flat file source component also works with the following connection managers for Dropbox, OneDrive, and SharePoint, with the Dropbox and OneDrive connections available in the SSIS productivity pack itself. For SharePoint support, there is the SSIS integration toolkit for Microsoft SharePoint available. Source file path specifies the location of the file that you are trying to read from. Next, you can specify the locale and code page of the file. The code page option will automatically default to the user's Windows regional settings. The next part is for column configuration. If your flat file's first row contains column names, you would select the first row has header option. When nullify empty strings is enabled, it will convert empty string column data into null values when writing to the SSIS buffer. The default to DTWString option can be used to determine whether applying SSIS type DTWString to all string type columns or using DTString with corresponding code page for string columns. The column delimiter option specifies how you would like to indicate the end of a column. The default is the comma character. The text qualifier is useful in the case where the data may contain a column delimiter. It is used to specify if your flat file has a symbol to represent when a field begins and ends. This is an optional setting in most cases. We also have an option to reset columns to remove any existing columns, which can be useful when you want to manually edit. Next, you will need to configure the columns you want to read data from. On the top left of the grid, you can see a checkbox, which can be used to toggle the selection of all available fields. The add and remove signs allow you to add and remove fields. The arrows help you move the field to another location within the file. Notice that all fields in the columns page are defaulted to be selected. You may use a checkbox to unselect some of the fields as needed. This is useful when some of the fields are not used in the downstream pipeline components. Doing so can eliminate SSIS warning messages that complain about unused SSIS columns from the source component. In the column properties window, there are values that can be configured in three ways: data type, length, and name. If the data type is a string, the length value is defaulted to 255. You can change the length value if needed. If the data type is not a string, this length option will be ignored. Import external column gives you the option to import the columns and its data type properties from a file, whereas export external columns allows you to save the columns and its data type properties to a JSON file for import later on in the same or different components. Let's click OK to finish configuring this component. The next step is to create a premium flat file destination component, which can be used to write data to a flat file. Let's drag the premium flat file destination component to the design surface and connect the two. As you can see, the destination editor has the same configuration fields for both the general page and the column pages. You would specify these settings, keeping your destination flat file in mind in order to write data to this file. This is your target of integration. Similar to the source component, the destination component can also select a local file as well as connection managers for Dropbox, OneDrive, and SharePoint. Destination file path specifies the location of the file you are trying to write to. Next, you can specify the locale and code page of this file. The code page option will automatically default to the user's Windows regional settings. The next area is for column configuration, where you can specify if the first row contains column names. The default to DTWString option can be used to determine whether applying SSIS type DTWString to all string type columns, or using dtString with corresponding code page for string columns. The column delimiter option specifies how you would like to indicate the end of a column with the default set as a comma character. The text qualifier is useful in the case where the data may contain a column delimiter. It's used to specify if your flat file has a symbol to represent when a field begins and ends. This is an optional setting in most cases. The Reset Columns button removes any existing columns, which can be useful when you want to manually edit. Now we navigate to the Columns page where we can pick the columns to write data to. The checkboxes Add, Remove, and arrow keys are pretty straightforward. In the Column Properties window, you can configure each column in three ways: data type, length, and name. If the data type is a string, the length value is defaulted to 255. You can change the length value if needed. If the data type is not a string, this length option will be ignored. Import External Column gives you the option to import the columns and its data type properties from a file, whereas Export External Columns allows you to save the columns and its data type properties to a JSON file for import later on in the same or different components. The last page is the error handling page, where there are three error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is Fail on Error, where the entire data flow task will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the Redirect Rows to Error Output, where the error output will contain the failed records with extra columns: Error Code, Error Column, and Error Message. There is also a third option, which is to ignore any errors that may have occurred. We have established our data flow. We can retrieve data from one premium flat file and write data to another premium flat file. Note that the premium flat file components that we offer in SSIS Productivity Pack are designed to have much greater usability when compared to the out-of-box SSIS flat file components. Within the control flow view, we will demonstrate the premium file transfer task, which is used to transfer files in addition to performing some basic file operations. The premium file transfer task has four actions: send files, delete files, create directory, and remove directory and its contents. Depending on which action you select, the next two areas for source directory and destination directory settings will vary. Checking the Continue on Error option will allow the component to continue processing the remaining items when an error occurs. When the error occurs, the task will report a warning message with some details that should surface in your SSIS report. The Send Files action will transfer all file and directory content from a source to a destination path. You will need to specify both the source and destination directory settings. This action also enables the option to include subdirectories, in which all recursive folders and file contents will be copied over to the destination path. You also have the option to overwrite existing items. The Delete Files action will delete all files within the path specified in the destination directory settings. This action also enables the option to include subdirectories. The Create Directory action will create directories within the path specified in the destination directory settings. You can also provide the name of the directory to be created using this component. The Remove Directory action will remove the whole directory, along with its file contents, within the path specified in the destination directory settings. In our example today, we will choose the Send Files action. I'll quickly configure this Control Flow Task component. This sums up the basic overview of our premium file transfer task. The premium file system source components can be used to read and retrieve file system metadata for the files residing in a local or network drive, or on a compatible connection such as FTPS and SFTP connection managers. Note that the file system source component differs from the premium flat file source components in the way that it primarily deals with file properties instead of the actual file content. Let's drag the Premium File System source component from the toolbox to the design surface. Double-click to open its editor form. We'll first select a connection manager. This component supports three types: local file, FTPS Connection Manager, and SFTP Connection Manager. The source item path specifies the location of the file or the folder that you're trying to read from. The item selection mode settings specify what sub-items, if any, you wish to retrieve. There are five options. The selected item option retrieves only the item specified at the source item path. The recursive option retrieves the item specified at the source item path and its sub-items recursively. The selected level option retrieves the item specified at source item path and its sub-items. The recursive files only option selects items the same as the recursive mode, but only returns files. The selected level files only option selects items the same as the selected level mode, but only returns files. Next, you will need to select the attributes from the object you wish to read from. Notice by default that all the fields in the columns page are defaulted to be selected. You may use the checkbox to unselect some of the fields as needed. This can be useful when some of the fields are not used in the downstream Python components. Doing so can eliminate SSIS warning messages that complain about unused SSIS columns from the source component. The columns page grid consists of five premium file fields. Selecting the file content will return the binary content of the file if the current item is a file. The full path is the path to the current item. Is directory is a Boolean specifying if the current item is a folder. Name will specify the name of the current item. Path to parent will indicate the path to the parent of the current item. Let's click OK to finish configuring this component. The next step is to create a premium file system destination component, which can be used to write data to a flat file. Let's drag the premium file system destination component to the design surface and connect the two. Let's select a connection manager. As mentioned before, this component supports three types: local file, FTPS, and SFTP connection managers. There are three actions to choose from: upload, move, and delete. The duplicate mode specifies how to handle rows that try to either move to or upload an item that already exists. There are three modes. The fail option will throw an error if the item exists. Please note that this can still be handled via the error handling page, which will be shown shortly. The auto increment option increments the number at the end of the item name. If one does not exist, it will be added. It continues to increment the number until no item with that name exists. The overwrite action replaces the existing item with the item being uploaded or moved to that location. Let's head to the columns page where you can map the columns from upstream components to the premium file system fields. Lastly, the error handling page has three error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is fail on error, where the entire data flow task will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the redirect rows to error output, where the error output will contain the failed records with extra columns: error code, error column, and error message. There is also a third option, which is to ignore any errors that may have occurred. Click OK to finish configuring this component. We have established our data flow. We can retrieve data from one premium file system source and write data to another premium file system target. This concludes a demonstration of our premium file pack components within our SSIS productivity pack. There are many other components in the SSIS productivity pack that enable developers to accomplish more in SSIS in a much more productive fashion. Please feel free to take a look at our other videos available for viewing on our website or YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to us.